All right, as you can tell, this is some sort of, this is a Lewis and Clark waterproof case. I'm going to show you both front and back, but I used it last year on the SDP, Seattle to Portland. And I'll use it again. This time I have my Nokia N97. I like that it has the light for dark situations. So the nice thing about this is that it's got rubber on the front, so I can utilize the touchscreen for the N97. And it's got a hard casing, plastic, very, very clear on the back, which allows me to get a crystal clear quality recording and still utilize the touchscreen interface of the device itself. Anyway, it's a relatively difficult case to find. I lost my last one last year, so I had to get another one, but I got it at a G.I. Joe's, and now they're out of business. Hopefully I won't lose this one, but this is a Lewis and Clark waterproof case. If you look up Lewis and Clark and then just kind of look for this yellowish, yellow clear casing, you should get in luck. You might be able to find it online. But it's soft rubber on one side, that's right here, and hard plastic right here. Good luck if you decide to record any water, any water situations, and you want to waterproof it. That iPhone deal is floating around on the internet that says that iPhone got dropped in the water. I highly doubt it, and I highly doubt that it actually survived it in the pool. It probably had something like this, which allows you to have the very clear recording, and goes for the soft front so you can actually use the touch screen interface on the device itself. Enjoy. Thanks for watching. Oh, well, I guess I could give a little demonstration too here. I'll run it underneath the water. So, there's the faucet. Dry inside. Not that you can really tell that. I suppose it's probably dry at all. Once I've dried it off, you would have my Nokia N95 in here last year. I still have that device. You can run the regular. Start touching the screen and messing things up. I don't really need to take it out, but you can tell. On a rainy day, or traveling the STP Seattle to Portland bicycle ride 204 miles, like I will tomorrow. I don't think I'm going to stream it live all the time like I did the ride last year, but I'll get some footage somewhere in there.